Hey, what is going on, everyone? This is iReviews back with another video, and today we're talking about iOS 14.3 Beta 1. A few days after the release of iOS 14.2, we have a new beta release. iOS 14.3 brings quite a lot of new features and changes to iOS 14. So in this video, we're going to take a look at this new update and see the 20 new features and changes that you will find on iOS 14.3 Beta 1. Alright, starting things off with the size of the update. iOS 14.3 should come to your device at around 5 gigs. That's the size here on the iPhone 11 Pro. Of course, it will be different on different devices as always. Quite a huge update. And moving on to the build number for this update is 18C5044F. This is the new build number for iOS 14.3. And now let's move on to the 20 new features and changes of iOS 14.3 Beta 1. We have quite a lot of new features and changes on the camera app and the camera settings as well. So if you go to the camera settings and you go to video recording, right now you will find here show PAL format. So basically PAL is the television video format used in countries in Europe, Africa, Asia, and South America. So if you want to enable these for your device running iOS 14.3, you can do that from here. So you can see you have the switch button to turn them on, and then you will also get right here the options for the PAL format. So you will basically get 1080p here at 25 frames per second, and also 4K at 25 frames per second as well. With iOS 14.3, Apple has also added RAW options for the iPhone 12. So if you have an iPhone 12, 12 Pro, you will get the RAW option on the camera app. Now, first of all, you will have to enable this from the camera settings. So you go to camera, under settings, of course, you go to formats, and you will have the option here to enable Pro RAW. Basically, this will enable it on the iPhone 12 Pro. On the camera app, you will see it like this. So these are screenshots that I took from Reddit, iOS beta on Reddit. So you will get the RAW right there. And of course, it can be enabled and disabled directly from there. So the RAW option on iOS 14.3, and you will get a little description right here on the settings as well. So each file that you take with a RAW option on should be at around 25 megabytes. Now, there was a feature on the Shortcuts app on previous iOS versions, I believe this was on iOS 13, that would allow you to create a shortcut, of course add an action, which allows to change the wallpaper of the home screen and lock screen of your device. That had been removed, and now it's back with iOS 14.3. So basically you go to add an action, and from here we'll add the option to set wallpaper. So just tap on set wallpaper, and then you will be able to basically create a shortcut that allows you to set a wallpaper. So you'll have lock screen, home screen, you can choose both of them or one or the other, and then of course set wallpaper to image. You can go ahead and choose the image right there which you want to set using that shortcut. So this is an option that has been brought back with iOS 14.3. Another change on the Safari settings: if you go to Safari and you go to search engines, right here we'll find all the different search engines that Safari offers. Of course, you can use each one of them, and now we have a new option right here. Ecosia is the new search engine that has been added with iOS 14.3. You can go ahead and basically use this as a search engine on Safari if you want to. So a new fifth option here under the search engines on Safari. With iOS 14.3, now you will see air quality reports for more locations in the USA. You will also get new locations for Germany, China, Mexico as well. So you can see right here under the weather forecast, there is the air quality, and now that has been supported for more locations. Again, more locations on the US, you will get Germany, China, Mexico as well. There are changes on the TV app as well. If you go to the search bar, you will notice now you can go ahead and browse by different genres right here. So here we have the different ones. We have the Apple TV Plus, the first one. Then we have here action, comedy, drama. We'll have all the different genres that you can go ahead and explore from here. So really great here to have this feature that basically allows you to just search, browse anything you want based on genre. This is something like the Apple Music. Apple did this with Apple Music since the first initial release of iOS 14. Now it's on the Apple TV as well. And also the search here has been improved, so you will get like better results, better suggestions and all that. So if you go ahead and search for something, you will see here the top results, and you will see all the different suggestions right there at the top. A new change also with Apple Music. Apple Music now uses the default system-wide video player of iOS. It didn't use this. Of course, this is new with iOS 14.3. This new video player that Apple Music will be using from now on with iOS 14.3 has been on various parts of iOS, of course, but Apple didn't add it to Apple Music. And now it has been added with iOS 14.3. Of course, it makes a lot of sense having this on Apple Music as well. When you open the App Store for the first time after updating your device to iOS 14.3, you will get this new splash screen right here, what's new with App Store and Arcade, and right here we'll see app privacy details, so you will get this new splash screen, nothing much new on App Store of course, but this new splash screen that talks about the app privacy. There is a new option under settings. If you go to privacy and go to analytics and improvements, you will have now the option to enable improved fitness plus. So if you have seen the iOS 14 presentation and all that, you know about fitness plus that Apple is adding. So now you will have the option to basically improve fitness plus under the analytics settings. There are updates on the health app as well. So now with iOS 14.3 and watchOS 7.2, you will be able to get notifications for your cardio. Also, if you go to browse and you go to different categories here, go to other data, you will be able to now find here the pregnancy data. So search for pregnancy right here. And here are the data for pregnancy that have been added with iOS 14.3 beta 1. iOS 14.3 also adds support for the new PlayStation 5 DualSense controller. So the new PlayStation has just been released, and of course now we have support for it, for the controller of course, with iOS 14.3. And there are also some features that have been found on the iOS 14.3 code. According to 9to5Mac, iOS 14.3 now will suggest you third-party apps during the process of setting up your iPhone. And according to the release note of iOS 14.3, now you can launch app clips by scanning app clip codes using the camera of the iPhone. So the default camera app, you just scan an app clip code and you will be able to launch the app clip. There is also an image found on the iOS 14.3 code that suggests the new design for the new Apple AirPods Studio. So those have been rumored to come for quite a long time. There have been rumors and leaks regarding the design of them. There is an image on iOS 14.3 that basically suggests their new design. And again, according to 9to5Mac, of course, based on code found on iOS 14.3, Apple is rolling out the groundwork to add support for third-party item trackers to the Find My app. And last but not least, let's talk about performance on iOS 14.3. So here we're on the Geekbench app and we have of course here benchmarks. We have the one from iOS 14.2, which is this one right here. So iOS 14.2, the single core score was 1,332, while the multi-core score was 3,378. And with the benchmark here on iOS 14.3, we see it's about the same on the single core score. So there's exactly the same 1,332, but we have quite a big increase on the multi-core score. So we have 3,494 on iOS 14.3, while we have 3,378 on iOS 14.2. Of course, again, great news always seeing an improvement on performance with iOS 14.3. So that's about it for this video, guys. This is iOS 14.3 beta 1. We should expect a new beta probably the week after this. So in about like it's right now, it's Friday. The beta has been released on the Thursday. So probably in about 11 to 12 days on a Tuesday or Wednesday, we should see iOS 14.3 beta 2 coming out. So that's basically it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. These are all the new features and changes that you will find on iOS 14.3 beta 1. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more. I'll see you on the next one.